So actress Charlize Theron went viral recently for defending drag queens. But before we get into the details, make sure that you like this video, subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell to never miss any of our videos. Okay, so during a digital fundraising event called Drag Isn't Dangerous, Charlize Theron said she would F up conservatives who think drag queens sexualize children. Here's the clip.
We love you, queen.
We love you, queen.
In your corner, and we've got you, and I will F anybody up who's like trying to F anything with you guys. It's really, in all seriousness, there's so many things that are hurting and really killing our kids, and we all know what I'm talking about right now, and it ain't no drag queen, because if you've ever seen a drag queen lip sync for her life,
yep,
it only makes you happier, it only makes you love more, it makes you a better person. If I could do a death drop right now, I would, but I would probably like break my hip. But and I, out there, please, please support all the great organizations that are out there helping all of this nonsense going away like it should. All of these incredibly stupid policies. Bye!
Bye!
No more room for hate! Only love, and love equals drag queens!
It only makes you happier. It makes you love more. It makes you a better person. Love equals drag. This is the exact opposite of what I actually think when I see drag queens. The event is trying to fight against laws that seek to ban drag on public property as well as in any locations where individuals under the age of 18 could be present. According to the website, they feel that these laws are more dangerous than banning the age-appropriate medically necessary care to transgender youth under the age of 18. What is age-appropriate medically necessary care for transgender youth? Chopping off breasts and giving puberty blockers to underage kids is medically necessary? Anyways, back to the whole point of the event and what Charlize Theron said. She thinks drag isn't dangerous, but instead makes you a better person. I guess this should be obvious when you look at a drag show, right? Let's look at a few drag performances to see if she's right. Like this person dancing in front of a small girl.
I need to know, could you be the one to call when I lose control?
The child looks disturbed. Look at her face. Does she look like someone who's enjoying herself? I don't think so. The adults in the room, on the other hand, look like they are having the time of their lives. This is just disgusting. It gives off strip club vibes and it's totally inappropriate for children. But this still seems more civilized compared to what I'm about to show you next. This next video is about a drag show for toddlers. Yeah, toddlers. Come on guys, just leave the babies alone at least. This is horrendous. This is not okay for adults, let alone for 2-year-olds. And this weird sexualized gymnastic performance is not the end. There's more. Here's a video of a so-called all ages family friendly drag show.
You are such an awesome mom for bringing your kid out to a family friendly drag show, ladies and gentlemen.
Are you confused yet? Cause I am. How on earth does anyone in their right mind think this is family friendly? What family thinks it's fine to expose their children to such highly sexualized pornographic content? What do these parents think they are teaching their children? What values are they passing on to them? A decade ago, exposing your kids to pornographic content would have been considered child abuse. Now? Wow, you're so progressive or inclusive. Parents are grooming kids into this lifestyle from the time they are born. Children are exposed to such hypersexualized content from such a young age in the name of teaching them about love and tolerance. How? How does allowing your child sit in front of a half-naked adult teach them about love and tolerance. How does this make you happier? How does this make you love more? How does this make you a better person? Here's the thing. Pride is a celebration of sexual orientation. Therefore, any event celebrating sex is inherently sexual. Drag queens are men dressed up as highly sexualized parodies of women who perform highly provocative sexual dances. It is not meant for children. It shouldn't be that hard to understand. So, what do you think about this? Are drag shows harmless entertainment that is safe for children? Do drag shows teach children about love and inclusion? Let us know in the comments below. Also, if you like this new format, let us know by liking and subscribing to our channel. Until next time.